first. So I'm here to post about a dream that I've been having as of lately. I've been having the same dream, and the story is very simple. I am on my laptop at my desk, and my older sister is writing in her diary in her bed. And an extremely tall guy keeps trying to enter our room. He was literally so big that his chest touched the threshold, and I couldn't see his upper shoulder at all. My sister and I knew that he wouldn't be able to come in anyway, so we didn't care about anything and did our own things. He bumped his body trying to come in, then finally gave up a while later and went back. And at that moment, I woke up. But recently, he keeps cutting his body little by little. By the third day, he hadn't been able to come in, but the day before yesterday, he was in front of the door, standing with his ankles. He cut off his foot. Of course, he couldn't come in either, and just yesterday, he cut off half of his calves. His shoulder was seen for the first time, but he has also kept bumping against the door. And this time was no different. What happens to me next if he cuts himself all the way to his knees? Second, it's me again, and I came back to post my recent experience. 2 days later, my worries became a reality. I had a dream again that day, and this time he really cut himself to his knees. I'm not going to explain all the details, but all I could see was his abnormally big mouth, and he was smiling brightly. Then I woke up. I was too scared to go back to sleep after just seeing his face. After that, I gave up on sleeping for a couple of days. I drank all night with my friends, went to a handicraft workshop run by my mom. I was playing on my cell phone for a while and napped for a while, lying down on my mom's lap when I felt too tired. Then I fell asleep, shallowly, on the sofa, and the man was there in my dream as usual. Fortunately, I was able to wake up right away because I didn't sleep deeply. However, being scared, I called my aunt, who was interested in spiritual existence at that time. When I confessed that I was having a hard time because of this, she told me that she knew a shaman and asked me to go there with her. No one believed such a thing because my family were all sincere Christians. My aunt was also a Christian, but she took me to the shaman saying that the method would be much better than just praying. Well, well, I guess these poor little lambs must have been desperate. That day, when I went to see the shaman, she said this to us just as I went inside. When my aunt asked what I should do next, the shaman said, "I'll give you an amulet. Put it on your door." Because we don't know if he was just joking around or doing it for a reason, we have to give it a few more days. Then she continued, "After I came back home with the amulet, I put it on my door without my parents knowing. I fell asleep in my room comfortably for the first time. And there was the man in my dream as I expected. But this time he wasn't standing, just sitting by the door and staring at me. I was inwardly admiring the effect of the amulets when I saw him like that. Just then, he began to imitate my dad's voice. "Lord, please take care of my family and look after my lovely daughters as if they were your eyes." He said a prayer like that almost every day, and while laughing, the man just recited the exact same prayer with my dad. Tears flooded with fear, and whether he thought that it was funny to see me crying, he began to mimic the barking of my dog this time. It was just surprisingly the same. He would scratch the door and whine when I closed my door to study, and the man made the same sound, scratching his fingernails on the door. The next was the voice of my friends. The moment I heard his voice, I was so scared and creeped out. Eventually, I could wake up shortly afterwards while I was crying in my dream. I called my aunt right away, and we went back to the shaman again. and I think we have to raise our prayer to God and do some exorcism sooner or later. I have been awake since that day. Of course, I've been eating my meals normally, but I kept losing weight because of a lack of sleep. I was going crazy. I'm still terrified, even when posting this right now. If anyone has experienced the same thing as me, please, please help me out.